lovely view.
Yes, isn't it?
I thought we'd never get away from the reception.
Well, your mother wanted us to be alone on our wedding night.
I think it was very considerate of her.
Oh, yes. Mother thinks of everything, doesn't she?
Do you realize you've only kissed me once today?
I'm sorry.
I realize a bridegroom is supposed to be nervous, but I think you're overdoing it.
Maybe.
The train leaves early in the morning. Phil, I want so much to make you happy.
I've done you a terrible wrong, Kate. I can't make you happy. I can't love you, Kate. I can't love anyone.
Bill, dear.
Don't pity me.
Heard about Bill. The police called hours ago. He was driving along the Lancaster Pike. There was an accident. He must have been going awfully fast. He was killed instantly.
Isn't he handsome?
You wanted to see me, Mike?
Well, I only stayed away so long because I thought for your sake I shouldn't be hanging around.
I appreciate that, Mike, but I think it's best if you didn't come here again after today.
Katie, I want to marry you. I love you. I always have.
I'm sorry. I can never marry you.
Why not?
Because of him.
Are you afraid what people are going to say? Oh, we don't have to stay here. The hell with them. We can go to some other town.
No, Philadelphia's our home. Oh, Tony, I try to understand you. Really, I do. But suppose someone had seen you fighting with that truck driver.
Mother, you seem to think that everybody in Philadelphia's got nothing better to do than to check up on Tony Lawrence.
Well, don't think they won't. Turn around. I could understand it if you were 15, but you're old enough to know now that you have to consider the consequences of everything you do.
How do you consider the consequences of a left hook?
It's nothing to joke about.
That is what I've been trying to tell you. My jacket in here?
Yes. You know, in a way, I hope you do lose that job. That's not the kind of work, and those aren't the kind of people you should be associating with.
Mother, no, we've been having this argument ever since I was in high school. Where else could I earn that kind of money?
Oh, I know it's very generous of Mr. Flanagan, but I was wondering... what time is Chet picking you up?
Oh, about 8:30. Would you like to join us?
Oh, Tony, now please listen to me. Isn't Chet's uncle a very close friend of the Rankins?
Yeah, I think he's dating the upstairs maid.
Oh, will you be serious? Mr. Rankin is on the board of several big corporations. Why don't you ask Chet to introduce
you? Mother, I try to understand you two, but Chet is a friend of mine. He's not a contact.
Well, what's wrong with asking a roommate for a favor?
Nothing, but not that kind of favor. I'm sorry.
You don't have to snap my head off. Tony, when you get there, I hope you'll be...
I will, Mother, I will. I'll be polite to all the old ladies, and I'll dance with all the wallflowers, and I'll make myself a lot of good contacts. Good night.
Well, have a night. Time.
swear the testimony you're about to give in the case not pending before this court will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do. I was having a light repast in the kitchen when the bell rang. As is my custom, I glanced at the kitchen clock on my way to answer it. It was precisely 8:43. Since my throat is a little dry, you'll pardon me.
Sound that awakened you have been the sound of a clanging garden gate.
Well,
five minutes before the shot was ever fired?
I don't know, sir. I
You're wonderful.
We're proud of you. Come on.